Hello, hello. So using the head planes that we had on the previous tutorial, I'll show you how I sculpt the facial features. If you haven't seen the head planes yet, feel free to check it out. First, I use a draw sharp to draw this shape. Something like a bird, I guess. Then crease for the vermilion border. Inflate this to make the lips rounder and closer. Remember that there's a protuberance on our lips, or we can call it a tubercle. One on the upper lip and two on the lower lip. I inflate it to make it a bit prominent. Go to profile view and I like to move this up a bit. This will also determine the thickness of the philtrum. Just inflate and then smooth the area around it. Then I use a draw sharp for the philtrum. And this right here where several facial muscles converge. We don't have to discuss each muscles. What's important is we know that they form this very prominent shape on the corner of the mouth. And just keep polishing. Everything here is already laid out for us, thanks to the head planes. It's just a matter of polishing at this point. I also like to use the inflate brush to make things more rounded. Next is the nose. So I smooth this first. And I use clay strips to build the nose wings. Go to profile view and make the tip a little more rounded. Then I carve in the nostrils using the draw sharp. I mark the forms of the nose first to help me define the plane change before I smooth. In sculpting the face, it's not enough to just know the bones and muscles. Instead, keep in mind that there are fats that influence the form as well. So here you'll see me using clay strips for the nasolabial fat. Then I carve in the nostrils some more. You can always remesh to rebuild the geometry and make the resolution uniform. Here I'm creating this bump where the cartilage and tissue meet in this area. There's a lot going on under our skin, but it's just important that you know that there's a bump in here. Or you can think of the nostril as a bean. The tip got weird on the profile view because of the forms a while ago, so just fix it. It's also important to know that there's a pair of cartilages in here, and in some cases, the space is wide, so you might see a groove on some people. And I think it looks cool. At this point, I want to smooth my planes, so I'm just masking the area where I don't want to be smooth. I use mesh filter and set the filter type to smooth. My mesh is too dense, so I'm having a hard time smoothing. So I just smooth manually and inflate some parts. For the ears, I mask this first, invert mask, and pull this out. Smooth and defined back of the ear. I just spread this a bit. Then draw this hook shape. Mark the ear hole. And make a couple of strokes. Go to front view and pull the tragus out. As well as this. We have blocked out the part of the ears basically, so it's time to join it with the head. Remesh and smooth. I just use a grab brush to move things to my liking. And crease to make things more defined. I shape the tragus using my grab brush. I think ears are often overlooked, especially when they will be covered by the hair anyway. But I really think they're important, especially when it comes to proportion, and there are also different ear shapes that could add to a character design. And I can't believe how much time I spent tweaking here, but it's okay. Here I noticed that the ear is too flat at the top, so I use my inflate brush to make it rounded. Then the eyes. I add a UV sphere, scale it down, and place it here. Move it forward, and this is important, move it up a bit. Then I model the iris and the pupil. Bevel this loop, select these vertices, scale it down, and push it in to make the iris concave. Then extrude for the pupil. Mask this area and just push it in. Don't worry if it looks funky, because we can always move things to get a better shape. Just remember to wrap the lids around the eyes and make sure to give it enough thickness. Here, I'm just sketching the forms. It's actually hard to sculpt the eyes if you don't have enough geo or a good topology. So you can either use dyne topo or do a retopo, but in this tutorial, I'll just settle for remesh. Just remember to check all angles and smooth or inflate when needed. And lastly, when looking straight, the eyes should be slightly angled. Then just keep polishing. That's all, and happy sculpting. Bye.